button.
We didn't talk about who's doing the intro. I'll do it. I got it. I got this.
You got it. You're the man. Listen. Let's go give it to you.
What's up, everybody, and welcome to the GenGAMEcast for Friday, October 21st, 2016. I'm Trevor Mignani, and today, at the GenGAME studio at Aeon Gaming in Deer Park, the only Kevin O'Rourke.
Wow. What an
intro. I didn't screw that up.
That was excellent. Excellent stuff.
Hi. Man.
Welcome to episode number 91.
91. We got there, folks. So for those of you who thought 90 was it, that was it. End of GenGAME. End of everything. No, we're back.
Yes.
We're back. Yes. 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 All right. Let's get into, obviously, the only gaming news of the day.
Yeah.
Red Dead Redemption 2, man. Of the year.
Yeah, the year's almost over, too.
I know. And I don't want to commit to doing another podcast next week right now. We'll see how it goes this week, and then kind of make a decision there. I don't know. We'll see what happens.
Okay.
I'm gonna pull Donald Trump here on this one.
Oh no.
We'll see what happens.
Okay.
I mean, if it's a fair podcast, we'll accept the results and move on.
Okay.
But if it isn't, then I don't know. We might contest it.
Wow. All right. What? Do another podcast to contest it?
I don't know. I'd have to go to a video review
or party.
Edit.
Well, that's George.
Yeah. Where's George the Bear?
Where's George the Bear?
He's actually sitting on the couch.
There, right?
Yeah, he's there. He's got his shades on.
I forgot about George the Bear.
Anyway, I think it's time that we just kind of recap what have we been playing for the past 12 months.
No one cares.
Just kidding.
No one cares. Let's do this. What are you playing this week? Because as we know on the GenGAMEcast, for those of you who haven't tuned in for the last 11 months. We have a lovely little segment that we start off every show with. I'm like red from laughing, not even from like heat or anything in here, just from laughing. We have a little segment that we always start the show off with called What Are You Playing? Where we go over what we've been playing for the past week. 11 months, a bit much. How about this week? What have you been up to?
All right, so probably I've actually played a few things. I've actually been playing World of Warcraft, been playing the Legion content, started getting into the raids and some of the end game content. So that's been actually a lot of fun. I'm having more fun than I thought I would. Aside from that, I played two games of League of Legends, uninstalled the game completely afterwards because I just realized why I don't like playing that game anymore. And it has a lot to do with playing with people that I know. But
it's a bad game.
It's also a pretty bad game. Yeah, it's not, though. It's fun to watch. But I don't know. Maybe I'll get into it again next season. But and then Street Fighter V. I've been really getting
here,
on this, yeah.
At Aeon Gaming, yeah.
We actually have we've got a weekly going here now. So every week, Mondays at around 6:30, I show up. We've got like at least three setups of Street Fighter V going. Sometimes we have more. Sometimes it's only three, but usually it's at least three. And we've been actually getting some pretty
Mondays
good turnouts.
Too.
Yeah,
Monday nights.
Yeah, we've been getting like 10, 12 people to turn out. So if you're in the Long Island area and you're looking to play some Street Fighter, Aeon Gaming is the place. $10 entry, $5 tournament entry. So,
okay,
not bad. It's pretty good value, and you get
you
to
watch
night.
Monday Night Raw, or you can play Street Fighter.
Yeah, I mean,
I'd take the Monday Night Raw. Sorry, but
can't handle
different dudes beating each other.
Yeah. All right, so Kevin, what have you been up to?
I've been playing a little Overwatch, actually. Overwatch and. Here's a weird, weird thing that I just got back into. Star Wars The Old Republic. Playing as an Imperial agent. Got to level 50. Double experience throughout the week.
Oh,
so
wow.
I was like, yeah,
why
not? You
just got there.
They showed off a really cool, I think it's for an expansion. I really don't know. It was a cool, like, short video. It's like a three and a half minute video. It might have been longer. I have no idea. It was cool. I was like, yeah, you know what? I have this game. I had it installed still. So
might
I was
as well,
like,
right?
Let's just play. So I've been doing that.
No harm in doing that.
That and a little Zelda. I just bought Oracle of Ages and Seasons.
Beautiful.
On the Game Boy.
Oh,
color
you got
carts.
The actual carts.
Yeah, actual carts.
Good for
pretty
you.
Pretty legit stuff. But yeah, it's been a busy 11 months, I'd say.
Yeah.
A whole year.
I mean, between all that,
time
I mean,
to renew and be
I mean,
refreshed.
I mean, between all that, we had the Zelda Dungeon Informer marathon,
which was a blast. Yeah.
Yeah, it was. That was some pretty insane craziness.
Yeah. Oh my goodness. Yeah. It's the week plus of Zelda. It's a lot.
God, the end of the week. What's funny is, like, at the end of that week, you just kind of, you're either in one of two mind states. You want to strangle everybody there, or you're like, man, I'm really gonna miss everybody.
Yeah. I don't know. I was.
I'm in the latter. Missing everyone. I miss everybody.
It was only, what, 3 months back, too. It feels like an eternity.
Yeah.
But it was only 3 months back. We're going to have a great marathon 2017,
yes.
I think so.
Anyway, there was some big news this week.
Huge news.
And in fact, we got the video, so we might as well just kind of... We'll start this off just by running the video.
Okay.
And we'll
play the video and take a look at the first look at Nintendo Switch,
so,
formerly known as NX.
So we'll be pausing the video throughout this. Just impressions and comments and observations. So strong opening here. If you, we got Breath of the Wild.
Space bar too.
So Breath of the Wild, good. We knew this was going to be there. We knew it's
great.
We know it's going to be
a
launch title.
Too. And there's the title.
Yep.
Nintendo Switch. The first look at the console too. Looks pretty cool.
The
I'm gonna pause
yeah.
there because I like the what are they called? Joy-Cons?
The Joy-Cons.
Which is like patented Nintendo.
That is a fantastic name.
That's a great name. I actually like the
Joy-Cons.
The concept of it. But what I'm scared of is those, like, let's say you're using this very frequently and you use the ability, which we haven't really seen yet, but I'm assuming if you're
using
watching
them
this,
as, like, nunchucks.
If you're watching this, you probably know a lot more than we
right.
do, at least about the Switch. I want to call it NX every time. I'm afraid of those connectors right off the bat, like, switching from this to the tablet and sliding them on, or just using them solo,
mm-hmm.
as we'll see a little bit later in the video. I'll keep it rolling. But I'm just initially concerned about that. Wear and tear, repair problems.
And the thing is, I feel like those are going to be like endlessly replaceable, which is good.
The bits, yes, but the tablet itself, I don't know.
No.
The Wii U tablet,
like,
getting that repaired is awfully...
Give it a pause. Never mind. Actually, we can...
Was this Rewind Theater?
We can. We're going to be IGN tonight.
Wow, okay.
Because
we
can.
Where's all the red? Yeah, huge Moblin. That Moblin is huge.
Yeah. So, taking a look at the... you can actually kind of annotate here with the mouse.
Okay, yeah. Let's,
so
let's
like,
cursor it up.
So, I think... First of all, like, this whole thing just smells like an NVIDIA Shield tablet with extra connectivity on the sides.
Funny you say that.
That was like my first impression. I'm like, oh, that looks kind of looks like a Shield tablet.
It does,
but
it's
what
it's
I'm actually most
thin, though.
What I'm most excited for about this, actually, more than anything, is you know how like sometimes your controllers wear out over time.
Yeah.
One of my biggest problems with the gamepad is how expensive is it to replace a gamepad?
It's like $150. Yeah. $150, $100.
Like, that's insane.
That's almost the cost of.
It's half the cost
system.
Of the Wii U.
Yeah.
So, like, if these Joy-Cons are actually pretty, like, reasonably priced, like, you have this system for 3-4 years, and the controller, your Joy-Cons are, like, worn down, they're not working as well as they used to, you could just swap them out.
Yeah.
That would be pretty freaking sweet.
Have one pink, one blue. I don't know. Will that even work? Who knows?
Who knows? I mean, there's nothing literally, and we're not going to find out anything else about the system this year.
This year or
this
week?
Year.
I heard this...
This
no, I don't know
year.
About this year.
No tech specs this year.
Wow, that's kind of
scary. Nintendo is being very tight to the chest about this.
So back to the swapping of the cart things.
Of the
Joy-Cons. Joy-Cons, slide, whatevers. Imagine like a different grip, a GameCube controller perhaps.
That's
maybe a fishing pole for bass fishing.
Now you're just in,
wow.
Now you're just bringing up a very specific Reddit post now.
Is that actually a thing?
You didn't see
thing?
That?
No, I didn't see that at all.
Oh, my God. I guess we can bring this up.
Maybe hook, like, a DDR mat on the side or, like, a Guitar Hero controller. Yeah. Definitely could be a thing. Or a nunchuck of sorts. Combining the best of Wii and Wii U. Maybe a Wii Zapper. Let's see what we got.
We're doing this on the fly here, folks.
This is intense.
Let's see. We're doing the whole OBS on the fly thing. All right, that's not the right screen. I think it's that screen. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so let's get over to that monitor and.
Man, I love the GenGAMEcast. We just do everything as we say it.
And I'm just gonna look this up on Reddit on the fly because I know
our gaming.
Yeah. Let's see. Where is it? Somewhere around here.
I got my Switch.
Yeah, there's some
it's
great
a tablet
stuff.
With.
Oh, no, here it is. Imagine the possibilities.
Oh wow! Yes.
Like somebody, literally, like this is posted.
Oh, GameCube controller too. Yeah. That'd be awesome, like for Smash Bros. Or a fishing game. Pokemon Snap. Oh man, that would be great.
Like, imagine all this stuff. Like, this would be pretty awesome. Yep. I'm not gonna lie. Like, and the possibilities literally are endless. And it makes the NX or geez, I keep calling it the NX,
the
Switch, the Switch, a more than just a video game console. It's this integrated experience, something that was very successful with Skylanders and Disney Infinity and Lego Dimensions, where you have these toys that come to life through these peripheral interactions, where you could have these special peripherals that connect to the Switch and give you extra functionality.
Yeah. Now, what I want to know is multiple Switches, or multiple tablets, I guess, for one console, probably not going to happen,
no,
right?
Similar absolutely to not.
Yeah.
Let's get because, the video right. So, because we'll get to multiplayer in this video. So, that's the whole console, which is pretty awesome. I mean, everything is packed into
now,
that box.
Picture Zelda.
So this is Kevin.
Marathon.
This is Kevin at the airport.
This is me and my future girlfriend sitting at the airport, going to the Zelda Dungeon Marathon, sitting down, boom, playing Ocarina of Time 3D.
All right, so I love the we got the headphone jack.
That's true. Wow, than Apple.
We got the headphone jack, folks. So we're
and
good.
It's not powered by USB-C. Now, I should say that Ocarina of Time 3D won't be on this, so what would I be playing as I'm practicing? Maybe Link to the Past Virtual Console?
Breath of the Wild.
Or Breath of the Wild, yeah. Nah, I'm not going to play that. I'm going to play Link to the Past and win again.
Oh, bold statement. So, one of the interesting things here is that you can slide the Joy-Cons off and hold them freehand.
Yeah, which is super cool. Like, and it's no attachment between the two of them.
Yeah. And my really biggest wireless. Question on that is, what the hell is the battery life?
I think you're lucky if it's over 3 hours, 3.5 hours.
With what they're expecting to have on these machines, like if you're going to be running Skyrim or something like Skyrim, because Skyrim wasn't confirmed, and neither was NBA 2K. But, you know,
what, confirmed to be
on the Switch?
But it's right there.
Nope. Nope.
What, are they watching a trailer?
Nope. Not confirmed.
Not confirmed.
Not confirmed.
Really?
Which I think was actually a pretty bad move by Bethesda and 2K to say, yeah, no, we're not committing to that because we're idiots and we don't want to sell games. Skyrim is an old game.
Well,
that could be easily
remade.
Ported.
It's being remade.
Yes.
Too. Their super version or whatever they're calling it.
The
legendary version?
Yeah.
Legendary Edition was the other one, but I think it's like enhanced. Whatever.
Whatever. It's a remaster.
Skyrim on
it's
a tablet.
Skyrim.
On your Nvidia Shield Switch, Nintendo.
Your
Wii U.
Your Nintendo.
Gamepad.
Your Nintendo Nvidia Switch.
It's not a gamepad, is it?
No, it's
I'm going to call it the gamepad.
But it's not. It's not a gamepad.
It's the console.
It's the actual console.
Now that's something I could get behind.
All right, so let's move forward a little bit here.
Okay.
Let's see.
I like that it said game card there.
Yeah.
See that? Zoom in right there.
Enhance.
No, game card. Cartridges. Cool.
Yes, and
they look
kind of
tiny.
They're pretty tiny. I think we get a shot at one later on in the video.
I have no idea.
But I mean, they're like 3DS size. Like
I know you're. Yeah, this. So look at this dude hanging out. Dude's asleep there in the center. Other guy's looking out, saying, "Oh wow, really high up." This guy's got his headphones on, and boom, his nondescript headphones, and he's playing his Switch with just you know.
Now, I'm going to go a little conspiracy theorist here.
What, are you looking for a wire?
Where is the wire going?
Where?
For the headphones. Is he sitting on it?
I see it kind of dip. Let's use the mouse. It sort of goes...
Where does it go?
Goes here, and then it goes down, and then you can't see it go around his leg. And then it goes behind, and then it goes through his jacket. Behind the jacket.
Is it?
All the way up to the other side where you can't okay. see it.
Because that was one thing that actually...
These ain't no Bose headphones yeah. either. It's not Beats by Dre. These are your Nintendo Switch headphones right here. No logo.
We're getting into the weeds here.
Headphones are. Yeah, that's a good point. Why is this guy so tired? He just sat down. What's he looking at? Who's this back here? I don't know. This person's reading a book. Who reads a book?
All right, let's
when you freeze frame, you really get to analyze.
I know. There's a.
All right, let's keep rolling.
I don't know. We give the IGN people a lot of crap when they do their rewinds, but
yeah. Now he's still right. playing Skyrim. Going to the bathroom. Oh
okay,
no!
Hang
I'm
on,
sorry.
Hang on. Try to grab this here.
What the door there? Oh, you're getting a little overzealous here. This is not our rewind machine. This is just YouTube. All right, relax there with the double clicks.
So we get a nice shot of the top of the system here. Well, not really a nice shot, but
a
slightly
a headphone
better
jack,
shot.
The so thing we, that's supposed so to be the game.
We've got our game card slot, headphone jack, what I would assume is the exhaust.
I'd hope. Goes right up. From the back of the console, on your docking station.
Now, there's something here. I don't know what that is, though. I'm trying to, like, bend the monitor to see if I can get some extra contrast, but...
It's definitely a thing.
Looks like there's something there.
I like the... it's got two buttons. I don't know if I like this particular side bumper, if you will. It looks super flat. I don't know. Sleek would probably be a word.
Let me see if we can find some better pictures of the... Of the good old Switch. Oh, it looks like
Polygon has the same freeze frame as us.
theirs is slightly better.
Which makes us advanced journalists, right?
Yes.
No, that's...
It's a slightly better
shot. It looks
shot.
A little better. I don't know. It looks just
we
as
can
blurry.
Enhance.
Whoa.
Oh. I think I... There you go.
There you go.
So... Looks like we've got a button. That's probably... Is that the power button, possibly?
I couldn't even tell you. It looks like a volume, too, next to it.
Because there's,
you
a,
have a,
there's
plus
a volume
and a
rocker.
Too, which I'm assuming is your start and...
yeah, plus minus, which is the new Nintendo start menu. Select. So we got headphone jack, game card slot, exhaust, some mystery thing here.
Mystery thing.
Maybe an SD card slot. That would actually be pretty good.
SD or...
SD would make sense, because Nintendo's kind of bought into SD cards being, like, the standard for them.
It's a good storage unit, too. It's a standard.
What looks like a volume rocker and a power button? Okay. I think we've got some... Actually, we had a shot of the controller, which... When I first
saw
this...
Pro controller, too. It's just the Pro controller.
It's an Xbox controller. It's great. I love it. I love everything about this.
Actually, you know what's funny is the bottom part, too, which I'm assuming is the, not for a headset, but for, like, player 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah, looks like the headset, right? Looks like there's some lights here, which is smart because, you know, Microsoft is a dumb company and decided, we don't need to put player identifiers on the controllers. The Kinect will figure
now
it out.
Now you've got Sony, on the other hand, that has
colors.
I like that. It's cool.
It's different. That is for sure. Yeah. Although there are two buttons here.
Probably some kind of
so
power off connect button.
I would assume that's the power button because there's like this little like circly
it's
line
the share
thing.
Button. You can share it right to Miiverse.
And then there's this this square button, which I would assume is like the menu or home button. Kind of like how the home button works right now.
Is it gonna be Miiverse or Switchverse?
Let's see.
What's funny is they've gotten all the same freeze frames that we have, which is good. That looks cool. Similar to the Wii.
It
looks like disastrous on your thumbs, though. It's going to hurt. Yeah. But you can play it. I can't think of anyone who's played Smash with just the Wii remote turned to the side. I think the only time I've ever used that was to play Mario Party for like one thing. Let's go back to the video. Let's scroll through because we're gonna see everything that they're looking at. Let's move this out of the way. So you're playing Skyrim on your Switch, and you fall right onto the couch as you're fighting the dragon with your battery life. That's awfully convenient.
Yeah.
Now, interesting here. I'm gonna pause this at a sec.
Okay.
I love the see it here.
I love the convenient mount.
Looks like it's floating.
It's actually, there is a mount that they slid it into.
Oh yeah, look at that. So,
which is actually pretty cool. Like that's pretty slick.
It's a bit more difficult to see, but I'll point it out with the mouse here. Trevor before was saying, "Oh, it's just Mario Kart 8 on Switch," but there are some key differences here. You've got Mario here on the left. And you've got Boo, who isn't in Mario Kart 8. Yoshi's Circuit here from the GameCube is still in the game. This is from Double Dash. So, speaking of Double Dash, you have two items. Two items.
So is Mario Kart 9 going to be like the greatest Mario Kart game ever?
It might be just a different version of Mario Kart 8. I don't know, 8.5, 9?
Mario Kart 8.5.
Mario Kart Switch. No, I find it interesting because there's only one.
You know, it does make sense, though, that Mario Kart Switch. I kind of wish they would bring back the double dash mechanic because I thought that was
pretty cool. I love
that,
or at least having the option to do it. Having a bike where you got Donkey Kong on it and Bowser, and it's just giant bike, and they're throwing stuff at you. Awesome. Good stuff. I love Double Dash. That was great. But it's not Mario Kart 8,
yeah,
which we'll look at for every video because so far all we really know is that Breath of the Wild.
Yeah,
it will be a
that's gonna
Switch
be a,
game.
Yeah, but now we know there's a Mario Kart. There's a Mario Kart game
is it
in development.
Be launch?
I would probably say anything you're seeing here is year one.
Yeah, so not even launch window. First 3 months, maybe one or two. I'd like to be inclined to think that this is gonna. Come
I will
later.
Put one. I will put one beer on the Mario on the 3D Mario game. Not being a launch window game.
No, I don't think so. I agree.
Mainly because they don't show a lot of it.
No.
They show 5 seconds of it.
I think what's key is probably not even 5 seconds.
It is. It is 5 seconds.
So I think what's key to note here is that your Wii U games from now till March are going to be like non-existent from Nintendo.
There aren't any. You have Breath of the Wild. That's it.
It's dead now.
The Wii U is dead.
So here's my reasoning for
why
these
I gotta tell Face to bury them. They're dead. They're useless.
They're not useless. They got Hyrule Warriors. So your ports of Wii U games may come to this, which would supplement the library by a lot because either if you have the Wii U and are buying this, are you going to buy it again? Maybe.
Now, what would be really cool is if any game on the Wii U that has Pro Controller support that can play exclusively on the Pro Controller would port to the Switch with minimal effort.
Yeah.
As long as they can write a hardware interpreter or some software interpretation emulation layer to play the Wii U games, because obviously you're going from a PowerPC-based machine to a
Tegra chip.
NVIDIA Tegra-powered portable shield. Monster.
A shield.
A shield, if I may.
But here's my theory here. It's just a theory.
Is it a
it's not
game
a, it's
theory?
It's a video game theory. It's a Switch theory. So it's not a string theory. Different S.
Okay, all right.
If development time for Wii U games that aren't going to happen is not happening, obviously, your focus is on the new console. With new games. So isn't that reason enough to say, like, well, this stuff has clearly been in development since Wii U, probably since before Wii U even
Right,
happened.
Right.
So I'd imagine they're pretty far along, and if you have this to show off that looks like more than just a tech demo, then at least it looks like it's more than just a tech demo. It could come out relatively quickly, I think.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah. I agree with that. I think...
So I think a year one thing is
That's why I said everything here is probably year one.
Okay.
Okay. Let's keep going. Let's keep rolling through.
So we got Mario Kart, and it's not Mario Kart
trucking.
8. And of course they. That's a better.
We get
shot
a nice
of it,
shot of this.
So we have King Boo there. We have Mario with the I think it's the B dash or I forget what it's called. But you can really see that the two item slots here. So Mario has two mushrooms, 10 coins, similar to Mario Kart 8. The UI looks very similar. The map in the middle, it's like damn near identical to Mario Kart 8. That skybox, though, looks nice. It's Mario Kart 8, but it's not.
Yeah, it's Mario Kart
Switch.
Mario Kart Switch.
Or 9, or whatever the hell you want to call it.
And then we immediately go to the go-kart analogy. All right, and now we're playing basketball.
Now we're getting into NBA territory. So this is cool, actually.
All right,
let's see. Yeah, we have NBA here.
So obviously, this is very obviously NBA 2K.
I'd hope so.
There's only one NBA.
There only
game.
Is. Yeah, NBA Live is.
NBA gone. Live is a joke. We also get a nice, better shot of the console here and the button layouts and all that fun stuff.
You can kind
of
see the jack, the game, whatever the heck this stuff is.
And there still is something right there.
Yeah.
And we don't know what that is. I still think it's probably an SD card slot. That would be smart.
Looks smaller. I don't know what it
could
be.
Well, no, it's a button that has like a little, it might have a tray there. I don't know. It's hard to tell. But
we won't know for a while.
So some things we can infer here, right? Make some good guesses.
Multiplayer.
Four-player multiplayer on two Switch setups with four total Joy-Cons.
Yes. So one that's with the system, and I'm assuming another one that's this dude paired to this.
Well, no. They're using the two that are on the
side.
Oh,
I see, actually. Yeah, they're holding them sideways.
Right.
So, okay.
So
player one, player two.
So what we can infer here is there's some kind of wireless communication happening. So probably Wi-Fi direct or a Bluetooth 4.0 or
maybe
something.
Maybe some kind of IR.
There is no IR, Kevin. There certainly is no IR, and I could put some money on that one.
Okay.
Although so if there is IR, I will be eating my hat.
So these devices are communicating with one another,
right.
Playing four-player multiplayer. Sounds like a good time for Super Smash Bros.
Which, surprisingly, we didn't see anything of.
No.
Which, I don't know. I'm not surprised. I think Nintendo's trying to cool off the Smash Bros. Crowd a little bit.
I don't know.
Because
it's got to be on this, though. It's a staple on every Nintendo system.
Well.
Including 3DS now.
Yes. So let's move on a little bit.
Sure.
So, I mean, and everything here looks like it's running very well, but obviously everything here is simulated.
Yeah.
None of these games exist yet.
They exist in our hearts. Maybe we want to talk about the controller here. This is different. So they're playing off the battery pack? I don't quite understand this actually.
This is a Joy-Con dock.
Okay.
That I would assume comes with the system.
Okay.
So this is probably the default configuration for the Joy-Con.
You can see the home button.
Yeah, that's a home button. Here. So we know that we're starting to unravel the mystery of what's going on.
Okay.
So maybe the square button's power?
Could be.
Who knows?
I hope
but
Nintendo
again,
knows.
We've got the
indicators.
The indicators. So player one. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4.
I like the logo too. It's simple. It's the controller.
Yeah.
That's what the football is here. So let's keep going.
All right.
Here's our 5 seconds of Mario.
5 seconds of Mario, which we'll talk about for at least 2 minutes.
Point out the amiibo here.
So I
the
obviously
numbered drawers, the plant, this awfully phallic looking gourd.
You know what's
things,
funny is I didn't realize any of this until you pointed it out.
Very sparse looking Mario, whatever this is, though. You're in some colorful world. It looks like a very place. I don't know if those are hearts. Or if that's part of the, it might just be part of the background because of course we're at a freeze frame. That bird though.
So we're on some kind of planet. There is a moon. The bird though. What about those candles? Those look like those have never been lit.
No. Who puts candles that close to their TV?
Somebody that doesn't
that
have
a Sony brand TV.
No. Actually, it's Panasonic.
Looks like it. Okay.
I'm actually very convinced it's Panasonic.
So you can see the console here. I love that they have the amiibo here, though, actually. That's kind of funny.
What's interesting is they don't show any amiibos being scanned.
No, they don't. But I don't think that's important. I think that...
To be honest, if somebody owns a lot of amiibo...
They've confirmed that they work.
Have they, though?
Yeah, they have.
All right. Because I want to see it. Okay. And to be honest, the fact that they didn't show that off, and I'm just realizing this now, that's a complete oversight.
There's plenty of things that they didn't show.
Yeah.
And that adds to the mystique.
All right.
So let's
get through the 5 seconds of Mario.
5 seconds of Mario. He jumps. He
jumps
again.
And triple jumps. All right.
It's a triple jump. And then...
All right.
That's it for Mario.
That's it for Mario. All right.
So let's go back to our literal 5 seconds and pause at the other frame at least.
All right.
Bullet Bill.
So we've got some ice in the background. There's some nice little effects there.
This is a game that I'm led to believe is not happening right away. It's literal no name, nothing about it. We're not going to know anything about it. But
and it looks exactly what really disappoints me about this one is that it's going to make it looks like it's going to make the same mistakes as 3D World.
Yeah.
Although I like that it looks more it might be a hybrid between 3D World and like a Mario Galaxy.
I'd be fine with that.
I think it would be the highest selling Mario game if they were able to go between the two of those.
Just the viewpoint that sort of top down isometric 2.5D for a precision platformer is like playing Marble Madness, and that's just not fun.
All right.
5 seconds of Mario. The fact that it's there is
good. A good old rooftop party. All right, yeah, we're gonna dock there. Up. No, she's the only one with the NX, the Switch though. So she has to bring it.
Got to break that NX.
It's gonna be so hard. All right, we're gonna all play some games now.
With your red solo cups. There you go.
And then okay, pause it here. Now I would like to point out we're at 2 minutes and 41 seconds. And that there is a significant amount of trailer to go.
Yeah.
And I would like to point out that Nintendo dedicated this much to pitching Splatoon as an esport.
Yes. Which is very important. Super duper important.
Which is like Nintendo finally realizing that it's 2016 and people like competitive games. And more importantly, people like watching competitive games.
Yes. Yeah. It's actually pretty important that they.
Although
show
I
here.
Think they're being a little.
A little overzealous.
A little.
Hey,
I don't know.
The Nintendo World Championships had a good crowd.
Optimistic would be the right word.
They had a good crowd. It was a fun event, and
it was
very enjoyable
to watch.
It was at E3.
Like, what else are you doing at E3? Like, to be honest, I don't think they would have caught anybody. I don't think they would have caught that kind of crowd if it was just the NWC by itself.
I don't know.
I do know.
I don't know.
Because. The entire tournament format was not conducive for spectators.
No, it was just
it was there for fun.
Yeah, it was a for fun event.
Like,
it wasn't
you had YouTube celebrities.
It
like,
yeah, it was YouTube celebrities and like pro gamers.
Like you had Cosmo Wright.
Yeah.
Or Narcissa now.
Wright. And Aaron from Game Grumps.
Yeah.
They're like, you know, just like hanging out. And it's like,
yeah, why not, Ego Raptors? Yeah, sure. You're a family friendly guy.
What's Aaron's credentials for pro gaming? I don't know. But he was really funny in, I think it was in Mario Kart 8, and they had the 200%, which was just like
the
200cc, which had just, just come out, and it threw everyone through a loop.
Oh, yeah.
They played the new maps. He's like, I've never played these maps before. And it's like, of course, like, whatever.
But it was a fun event. All right, let's go through
one
this.
More thing before we do this. Note the amount of 20-somethings and 30-somethings in these videos. And note the marketing of who it's going towards. I'll leave it at that. Let's watch. And of course, that's what this is what pro gamers do. They have whiteboards and chalkboards.
Yeah, of course. Like if you go to any like
and pro controllers, of course.
Yes.
In uniforms, I like the purple. And it's true. There's a lot to like. It's a good chunk of the video. So this would be Nintendo's Splatoon event. In an esports setting.
Yeah.
Everyone docks in. Of course, they bring their own Switches because that's allowed. And everyone's amped. Look at that arena. Let's go back.
Hang on.
Let's go back.
Half that arena is empty.
Hold on. Let's analyze here.
All right, Nintendo. I don't buy this.
Yeah, actually, it does look a little sparse up there.
No.
Are those people or are they CG? What about over
here?
This
is all
CG'd. Still cool. Like, the concept of it is cool.
The idea.
An entire arena filled
thing.
With people to watch Splatoon. Confidence in the system.
I mean, right now, I mean.
Oh, no, we're pulling up another source. Let's stick to this video.
I mean, right now, I mean, over in good old Madison Square Garden, we've got
167,000 plus people watching.
Yeah. We've got this going on, which is actual esports. With an actual, like, this is how you esports in an arena.
I mean, if you look at it though, I mean, the video itself seems to point that this is what's going
to
happen.
So I'd like to come
Madison Square Garden.
This is actual. This is Nintendo.
Yes.
Nintendo. If you wanted to sell this, you got to make it look like that.
It looks sort of like that. Look.
You see how they're using the Jumbotron, though?
Yeah.
You don't do that.
That's fine. It's fine. The point is that esports for Splatoon.
Yes. All right.
And it's there.
Oh, crap. Nintendo this game it's actually did go to a Game 5. That's pretty intense.
March 2017.
I was going to go to this. I'm kind of mad I didn't now.
So that's what we've got. Let's pause this.
All right.
Goes to Breath of the Wild. E3.
We're not even going to get to that today, even though there was a ton of stuff going on with Breath of the Wild, but...
So let's take a look at this. I have Nintendo everything here because that's all I tweet. Do we want to talk this already?
Yeah, let's just go. Let's jump in.
I have five articles. I think I have five. Five articles. Four from Nintendo Everything, one from Polygon, because I felt like mixing it up.
Okay.
So
okay,
this.
Hang on.
Okay. Let's look at the title, even though it's the same. Nintendo Switch, a look at partners working on the platform. Third party.
Yeah.
Third-party developers.
Bring that up.
Decent mix of people. Now, I seem to recall a similar sort of something with Wii U, and that fizzled. And I think one of the biggest ones was this offender right here. Ubisoft just said, we're not going to make any Wii U games because we don't believe in the platform.
Well, because it wasn't standard. That was the biggest issue. And I agree. Like, that's... to be honest, like, it was not a great fit for them for what they were trying to do. Even though, like, they could have probably done some cool stuff with the Watch Dogs franchise or any of that, but it was too non-standard.
Yeah, I think the big ones that stand out here are Take-Two, Koei Tecmo, which actually isn't that big of a deal because of Hyrule Warriors. But From Software being on
From
here.
Software is a big one.
Capcom being on
an
here.
An interesting one is
Atlas.
Codemasters.
Where is right here?
They're the guys that do the Dirt franchise.
Yeah, interesting. We actually didn't see any racing games from the aside from Mario Kart. Everything else seems either smaller or more standard things that you'd expect. Activision will latch onto anything that breathes.
THQ Nordic, so Darksiders. Also.
Yeah, THQ Nordic. I saw that there. Darksiders, I feel like, is usually just what was it? Darksiders 2 was released on Wii U super duper late.
Yeah.
The rest of the stuff, standard.
But I mean, like,
things.
There's. Let me get rid of the camera
a little
here,
bit.
So that way we can.
So we can see this
the rest
side
of the
here. Telltale will run on like whatever they want on a toaster. Havoc, Unity, Warner Brothers.
Well, I mean, like, let's talk about some of these other things that are just super important. Like, for example, TT Games. That's an important developer to have on board. Epic Games, Unreal Engine. That could help draw.
There's a lot of
TT
games here. Take Two, Telltale. Sorry. A lot of TTs. Like TT from Diddy Kong Racing. What a throwback.
Oh, boy.
No, it's a good mix. And I like how they say a sampling of partners.
Capcom is interesting. I don't know what we're going to see out of Capcom, but.
Who knows? But a ton of indie developers have jumped on board, too. I saw Yacht Club Games. Frozen Byte, which I throw in as an independent developer. A few others on there. Spoink.
It's good to see Cryware's on board.
Cryware. Oh, God. Where are they?
What are you saying? Oh, God. Oh. Why are you going to rip on Cryware? They're one of the most visually compelling
developers. They are. I didn't
developers.
See them. CryEngine.
Yeah.
They're here.
Havoc, which is another engine, which is good to see.
Unity.
Unity runs on a toaster, man. Like, it's like whoop-de-doo.
Inti Creates is cool to see. Atlas.
Yeah, I mean, you've got the ones that you need to see.
North American.
Square
folks.
Enix.
Level 5.
Level 5.
Konami.
Platinum.
Koei Tecmo. Standard stuff. Not surprising. Cool to see. I think third-party support is critical for it to staying alive,
right.
and
then, like,
you know, not fizzling
like
Wii U.
The most important ones, just going from the top to bottom. Activision, important. Bethesda, important. EA, super important.
Yeah, EA is money. Take-Two is money.
Sega, because supposedly the new Sonic games are not going to suck.
There you go, Sega.
Important stuff. Square
Sonic
Enix.
Mania. It looks awesome.
Yeah, I'm sad we didn't get an episode to discuss that, but
it's fine. We'll talk about it next week.
Have we decided on that already? No. All right. Keep going through here. Square Enix is important. Take-Two Interactive. I mean, who knows what we'll see out of that? Could it be Red Dead Redemption 2?
Could be. Could not be. I don't know. I think what's important here is more so the engine guys, because it's running on this funky chip.
Yeah. Well, the thing is, they have already confirmed Unreal Engine 4 support, which is big. So that's what a lot of the guys are doing. Like, for example, like Street Fighter V, for example, is a Unreal Engine 4 game, meaning they could literally port that thing to pretty much anything, even though that game is a PS4 console exclusive.
But they could.
Exclusivity
doesn't last as long as it used to.
So far we've gotten a year out of Street Fighter, so.
Okay.
Even though my PCs would like to remind it that it is not a PlayStation exclusive.
Yeah, whatever. That's fine. Only on PS4. Let's keep rolling.
Okay.
Speaking of NVIDIA and NVIDIA Shield, I thought this was interesting. I thought we'd just pull it. NVIDIA working on Nintendo Switch.
Now, is this
the processor?
Is this official
thing.
Or is it a...
There's a statement.
Oh, hang on. Yeah. So the first thing you know about the new Nintendo Switch Home game console, it's really fun to play, great graphics, loads of game titles, incredible performance. Nintendo's biggest problem has always been performance and that their systems could not keep up. This generation in particular, the Wii U, Xbox One, and PlayStation 4,
they're all
suck.
On different levels.
They all suck, though. And I'm here to just, like, fire shots at everybody.
Well, they're all already out
they're
of date.
Awful.
They're out of date on arrival.
They were awful from day one. Like,
that's true, yeah, because the games couldn't hit.
Well, not only the games, the interfaces sucked.
Oh, I hate the Xbox One. That stuff crashed.
They finally
on me
fixed
so
the
much.
Xbox One's UI.
Well, Xbox, well, because it's Microsoft, they're all software, but that should have been there.
Well,
from
I mean,
the
PS4 is still a joke.
We were saying this as we're running this off Windows 10 on a Microsoft box.
Yeah.
But no, I agree.
The Wii U is a,
too.
Not
it's
even
its own thing.
Oh God. The Wii U's UI leaves a lot to be desired itself, but maybe they'll get it with the NX. Something simple and fast.
They might even get it with the Switch.
I'm still gonna call it the NX.
That's fine. Call it NS. I don't think NS rolls off the tongue.
The NS does not
just,
work.
You're just trying to say NX. No, right. I mean, it's just them saying,
yeah.
You know, we've optimized
the
whole suite of hardware and software.
But here's the most interesting part, though, is that this is a big shift for console gaming. This is going to be the first major game console to be an NVIDIA-powered solution.
Yes.
Actually,
not an AMD.
Actually,
one.
No, I might be lying there.
Well, out of this group, PS4, Xbox One, AMD stuff. AMD hardware.
Because I think the original Xbox used an NVIDIA chip. Yes.
Okay.
It did. So this would be the second.
Tell you what, though, that's a long time ago.
Yes, that was
It's a very long time.
That was back when Pentium 3s were cool.
Yeah, they were.
And you could actually, like, the original Xbox actually had, it was a 733 megahertz processor. Gosh. Back when that was
the
hot.
The Direct Xbox. But no, it's interesting. I'm hoping that the cost for this will be lower, and the more people that buy it, the cheaper it will become.
All right, so
is it going to throw off developers? Probably.
So where do you think this needs to be priced?
So it has to be under 350.
It has to be under 350. I think that if they want this thing to sell, they need to be at this price point.
$200?
$199 okay. Shipped.
Okay.
And anything more than this, and the Switch jeopardizes everything.
Okay. You think it's DOA?
Absolutely.
I'd say 300 and under. If it's over 350, that's a huge problem.
If it's over 250, I think people are going to balk at it.
Okay. $250.
$200. That is almost impulsive in this economy.
Yeah.
For a console.
I mean, I'm going to buy it anyway, but 200 would be great.
200 would be incredible, because then
that's including your the tablet,
Joy-Cons.
The Joy-Cons,
and the dock.
Not the Pro, the dock, and maybe a digital throw-in. I don't know.
No, $200. No, this is what I want to see
for the console.
I want to see $200. For the Switch, which includes the screen, the two Joy-Cons that go on the side, the dock, the power cord, and an HDMI cable.
Okay. $200.
$200. You have my money.
Let's hope that screen's cheap to produce.
Screens are cheap to produce now. They're not putting a crazy screen in this. I can guarantee you.
Okay.
Like the Shield tablet itself.
I mean the tablet, not just the screen, but
like the Shield itself is a 8-inch 1080p screen.
Okay. Something similar?
Like
running a Tegra processor?
Yeah.
Maybe they recycled all the Shields and they're just turning them into Switches.
I mean, they're powered by Kepler GPUs, so.
Yeah. Cool stuff.
They're pretty much there. But
$200 would be great.
Like, in the box, like.
Obviously, we're going to see some kind of Zelda bundle.
Yeah.
Whatever else comes out at launch bundle. Maybe one that has the Pro controller with it.
Maybe. I think they need to keep all that separate. I think Nintendo's got it right with what they did with the new 3DS, where they just sell you the console.
And no
no power cord. Because they realize people are just buying the new system.
Yeah.
So they already have a power cord. Like, don't include stuff you don't need.
Could happen. We have couple months.
Yeah. But, I mean, like, you look at the specs. You look at the specs of the Shield. And it's got pretty much everything you want to see.
You think it's going to be comparable?
Here's the big kicker, though.
Yeah.
Because it is an NVIDIA-powered solution, and it's a modern NVIDIA-powered solution, you are getting 4K support. Now, I'm not going to say that the Switch is going to have
4K.
The Switch. I did not say the Twitch.
Okay.
I might have mixed my words together, but I meant to say the Switch.
Okay. So what's the NX doing?
The NX is dead. It's buried with the Wii U's.
Oh, man.
But seriously, it definitely needs to have that HDMI 2.0 port on it for 4K support. Even if the games aren't rendering in 4K, that's not important. Being able to just support the displays is enough.
Okay. I'm going to throw a spin at you. VR ready, not important.
Not important
at all. In Nintendo's mind, not important.
In my mind, it's not important.
I don't think it is either. I've done VR. It's cool, novel, fun.
Have you tried PSVR?
I have not tried PSVR.
You know what's funny? Oculus Rift. They've had it set up at Best Buys that I've walked into like 6 or 7 times.
They have the Vive at the one near me. At GameStop near me.
And I've wanted to try it, but there's always a line.
Oh, yeah?
Which is insane. So, like, I'll sit and I'll watch somebody playing the demo, and I'm like, oh, man, that looks pretty cool. But I don't think it's there yet.
No, I think it's a few years out.
What I really want to do, because we have a crazy amount of space here at Aeon Gaming, I want to get a VR set up here.
Okay.
And set up the back with, like, a crazy big amount of space, we're gonna go crazy one day.
Okay.
There's gonna be a.
This sounds expensive.
Yes.
That's the problem. It's very expensive.
I'm gonna buy a Vive, and
it's super expensive.
I'm gonna take a mortgage out on a Vive and a computer to run
you
it.
You need a lot of space.
Well, the good news is we have a lot of space here.
Well, I'm saying though, as a consumer, yes. Like you need a lot of space,
right.
And for this, you don't. It's you literally need the screen right in front of you and just the Joy-Cons.
Yeah.
You don't even need a big controller.
Right. So anyway, spec-wise, hitting that $200 price point, I think, is more than possible, especially with the economies of scale that Nintendo's gonna enjoy with making as many systems as they're going to,
and hopefully selling that many. Not having
at $200, it is
$200.
Like I said, $200, it is
a
almost no brainer.
And $200 would be cheaper than 3DS at launch,
right? And that's the most
just
important
the handheld,
right?
It's not a handheld; it's a
exactly
handheld
it's
and
a
console.
Full
it's a console.
Console. It's such a ballsy move, but if they do it, they can get a huge install base.
Yeah.
Because anybody like what does the 3DS XL go for?
Oh shoot, I think it's at $250.
The new 3DS XL goes for about $200.
Okay, I thought it was that.
I'm a little jaded on my pricing because I bought the capture one.
Oh yeah, well that was
that'll definitely do.
That's definitely your own thing. No, I don't know. Seems cool for that price at least. That would be super duper. Do you want to keep rolling to my next?
Yeah, let's roll on to the
article.
Next.
I saw that. I wanted to bring this up because we looked at it, we talked about it, but I just love that picture. King Boo on the roster, two item slots are featured. We might be getting Mario Kart 8 on Nintendo Switch, but there will definitely be some changes if it's the same game. Now, question to you, hypothetical stuff. Will Nintendo port Mario Kart 8 to this?
I think it'll be a completely different game.
Is it going to be a shot in the arm to say we have all these Wii U games that no one has experienced yet, port them on this, let them, you know, buy this again?
So
or
I'm
going to
click
say
on this next story here because this is answering the question everybody wants to know.
No physical backwards compatibility. Cartridge based.
Right.
No optical drive. No CDs.
So another thing too, what are those like little squares on the side there? Are those
these
USB
guys?
Ports?
I think they're USB ports for your Smash GameCube connector.
Because like
definitely,
if those
probably
are USB ports, Nintendo might have done it.
USB-C?
No, it'll be standard A ports. So this article actually gives us a lot of information too. Because they said that there's no physical backwards compatibility.
Kind of funny.
But they don't say that all backwards compatibility is not possible. So
digital downloads?
So digital downloads might move over, but I think it's going to be one of those all or nothing kind of deals. Like, you're going to do virtual console for those types of things, I think.
Can't say for sure.
Yeah.
We can only think and hope and chat about it right now.
The battery life question, too, Nintendo dodged like a quality political candidate. Merely saying the device was designed so that players could play as comfortable as possible, even in a place where you have no power supply.
For 3 hours.
Oh, God. That was the
best.
That was my biggest problem with the 3DS when it came out. It was such a cool device, and it had the crappiest battery life. My unit died on the Ocarina of Time launch. Like,
oh, that's bad.
Before I even got home, I'm like, all right, we're gonna street pass a little bit. I'm like, oh, we're down to one bar. I'm sitting in Penn Station waiting for a train, and
you're not charging it on the train either.
No, I was. I had it in my cargo shorts, and I'm like, all right, well, we're gonna play up until wherever we can until the light starts blinking, and I did not get very far.
That's handheld for you, and that's going to be the same thing for this. Maybe you'll get some attachable battery pack. Maybe you can swap out the Joy-Cons for extra batteries on the sides and a little Game Boy light that shoots down at the top so that you can see the screen better. That's fortunately not a problem anymore.
Yeah. But
it is interesting to
but
see.
But the thing is, like, Nintendo's dodging all of the hard questions for this year.
Yeah.
Which means we have to wait 2 months now before we get anything else on a console coming out in 5 months. Oh my God. You know what? You know why that makes me nervous? Because it might actually give some weight to the idea that they might try to sell this thing super cheap.
You just wanted it super cheap, so do I.
Right, but this is giving validity to it.
Cheap in quality.
But this is giving validity to that because they don't want to blow their smoke here and have everybody like, oh, well, now Sony's going to come out with a new Vita that's at a lower price point.
I get what you're saying, like competing with it and saying,
or Microsoft or anybody trying to do something like this, even though I think Microsoft has purposefully shown their hand saying, we're going to be in this space. We're going to be in this space. Don't go after it.
Pull up the camera. Nintendo's competitor is this.
Right.
In your mobile market, this is what's taking game sales away from a 3DS. It's your phone.
Right, absolutely.
It's small. You're always on it. It has more utilities than just a game console.
But the thing is, what sucks about my phone is, if you look at my battery life currently, it is at 31%, and I don't play games on this thing.
No, yeah.
This thing is literally useless to play games with.
But you're on the go. You have valuable. It's probably 20 something.
You're getting down there.
A lot of tweets. Your pocket space is limited. Can you jam this thing in your pocket and take it with you? No,
dude, that thing is like a six.
It's big.
No, it's probably like an 8-inch screen.
So it's something that you're bringing along with you, like an iPad.
Yeah, that's fine. Like, I think people are okay with that.
Yeah.
Hence, look at the sales of 2DS units.
I don't know what they're at, but I'd imagine
they're selling.
That's pretty decent. Yeah.
The fact that it exists as a product is proof that people don't care about the size of the device if they have something to carry it in.
Yeah. But all that aside, the point I'm trying to make is that your competitors for mobile is not Sony with their Vita. That's
dead.
Basically cut.
Sony
like Sony has cut the Vita more than Nintendo has cut the Wii U at this point.
And that's pretty impressive.
And Microsoft is so far out of the mobile market. Microsoft's phones aren't even in the mobile market at this point.
And the thing is, that's why Microsoft came out with Project Scorpio, and they said, hey, this is the space we want to be in. We want to be in the high end. We want to be in VR. We want to be
PC.
We want to be in the power position where we're providing a premium experience.
PC, Windows 10, Xbox One, or whatever the Scorpio is. Xbox One S, if you will.
Well, that's
on top of that too.
Well, yeah, you have the One S that just came out, which is, in my opinion, a better value than the PlayStation 4 Pro. But that's a whole other discussion.
It's PC that they're in. That's their
thing.
Well,
the thing
having
is,
Xbox
Microsoft
has that brand.
Well, that's the thing
is,
Microsoft is going. It's everything for Xbox.
Yes, they want to be one,
which
single
means
solitary platform.
Right. One
Xbox
platform and treat it as a platform, which is something I've told Microsoft. I said that Microsoft needs to do
since the 360.
Yeah, like stop treating the Xbox as a physical piece of hardware,
as a box,
and treat it as a platform, which is what they've tried to do with games for Windows Live, trying to integrate the Live accounts, and now with Play Anywhere. What are you trying to do? I don't even know if I have the Xbox app installed.
Should.
There it is.
Oh, look at that. Xbox and Smart Glass. It's built in.
I still have 360 Smart Glass installed in this.
Your OS has Xbox. It's right here.
Yeah.
Sharing games. Sharing games across this. Like, it's going to be a no-brainer.
But that's the thing. Is like, Microsoft is finally figuring it out. Like, hey, like, people want to buy once, play anywhere.
Yeah, and that's not Nintendo's shtick. But
Sony
now
figured
that out. Nintendo's cutting out the middleman by saying we're going to have one system that could do both.
Right.
So just buy it once on our system.
Buy it on the Switch, take it with you.
Yes.
That's great. So final touches on hardware. So in addition to HDMI power, what looks like some USB ports.
Let's cut over to this as you say that. Get a little shot of the controller and know that the hardware is not equivalent to your Wii U. Is that what you're trying to get at, or you're talking about buttons?
I'm talking about buttons. I'm talking about ports.
Okay, so let's go back and let's talk about buttons. Buttons and ports. We don't really even know.
Yep.
We just kind of know. Let's go basic with this. You have the dock. You have the console. It's got a game cartridge slot. It's got the Joy-Cons that you can put on the side. Anything else that we know, I'm assuming it has a power button?
Yep. We're going to assume it's got a power button.
And that's it. Touchscreen, not touched upon at all. Pardon the pun. Is it a touchscreen?
I'm trying to see. Well, I actually don't think it's going to be a touchscreen. It might, though.
In this day and age, if you give anyone a screen,
they're going to assume it's a touchscreen.
They're going to assume it's a touchscreen because of your phone, because of your iPad, because of everything. Like, you give this to someone, and they're going to instinctively try to touch the screen or something. And that's anyone. That's any age, any size, any gender, any height, any whatever. Anyone, any human creature on this planet will think that a screen is a touchscreen. We're in the future.
So, I think we're going to have those are USB ports. They look like
they
USB
look
ports.
Like USB ports. What are they? What else could they be? Display ports on the side here?
No. So, assuming those are USB ports, like, this could bode well for the whole situation that I was talking about before, which is, or that I was alluding to, is this thing needs to have all the connectivity options in the dock possible. So, no matter what, you can get online with this system, and you could use the system as you want to.
Yeah. Over some kind of local area network.
Yes.
One would hope. One
that
would
is
hope.
That is my biggest fear, especially because at the end of the video, they showed off that esports event. I'm like, man, that is awesome, but I hope they're not playing over Wi-Fi, because we know Wi-Fi sucks.
Yeah, and Nintendo demos definitely know that it sucks too. Wireless
and,
anything.
And one of our cohorts from Zelda Dungeon knows that it sucks.
Yes, it does.
So
you definitely want LAN.
And if those
no
are
exceptions.
If those are built in. Yes. That'd be perfect, but knowing Nintendo, there won't be a LAN port built in, and instead we'll rely on these USB jacks.
Yeah. End of the world, not really. No. Your standard consumer, especially to do this on the cheaps, will cut down the cost. But how expensive is it to throw an RJ45
jack? Maybe like a few bucks. Probably
per
unit? Probably $2 per unit.
Per unit adds up. But you know what? I'd pay the extra $2 to have it in instead of buying a $45 adapter.
I already have one, so Nintendo, feel free to exclude it, man. Feel free.
It's a no-brainer. You got to have LAN. Any docking station that you go to purchase for a laptop in a business environment or otherwise, you have LAN, you have USB, you have some kind of video port.
Talk to Apple, talk to Microsoft, talk to Asus, Dell, and
HP.
They're all getting rid of those jacks.
Oh, what, LAN jacks?
Yep.
On their devices, yes.
Yes.
On their devices, yes. But on their docking stations they're selling?
Oh, yeah. No. Yeah, the docking stations.
They're still there.
Yeah.
No, every device is losing it now. You especially talk to Apple. It's one port. One port's all you need on your MacBook. MacBook?
Oh, God.
Not the Pro, just the MacBook.
The MacBook is a joke.
It is.
But, I mean, speaking of routers, I mean, like, you get crap like this now that comes out where you have...
Fiber port?
You have the...
Oh, that'd be interesting. What if the Switch is a fiber port?
Yeah, the 10 gig fiber port. Although, to be honest, my company might actually buy one of these to replace our existing Nighthawk because it does have the fiber jack.
Okay.
And we have a fiber switch that's currently being underutilized.
Go for it. Seems a little Rolls Royce, if you ask me. Look at that. What is this on the... I can't even move this mouse. What is all these things on here? Is that all your ports?
These?
Yeah, what is
those
that?
Those are lights.
For what? Everything you can put in?
Yeah.
How many ports does this have?
It's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 Ethernet ports. 2.4 gig Wi-Fi, 5 gig, another Wi-Fi, another status, internet, something else. Those are two buttons for like WPS and something else, but...
This is insane.
Oh, yeah. It's insane. It's also $500.
Wow. It's more than your Switch.
Yeah. Well, actually, no. My...
No, I mean your...
Oh, the
Nintendo Switch.
The Nintendo Switch, yes.
Yeah, your Switch might be more. I hope it is.
Yeah.
Your actual network Switch.
We spent a lot of money on that one. Well, it's PoE Advanced, so...
Okay, good. So you're kind of covered.
Powers all of our phones.
Good.
Well, and when the power goes out, it still powers those phones for like a solid like 2 hours.
Okay, well, not bad. Phones don't need much to run. All right, let's go into our other article. We have two more. Two more, and then I think we'll wrap
two
it
more.
Up.
Oh man,
because I think we've touched on a good couple points.
I think so too.
Agreed on most, maybe disagree on the price. All right,
let's
brought up a good point with the Switch. With the,
so this
is pretty,
this is an obvious one.
Maybe it wasn't so obvious to people. I
don't know. I think
I beg to differ because I think that your average consumer who bought a Wii U would assume that it's the same deal with their new system.
You know,
build off Wii U, but that's an uninformed consumer.
But it's so painfully obvious what the system is now that it's almost stupid if you think that you're going to use that as an additional gameplay screen while it's docked.
I'm sure people are still because thinking that they're going to have backwards compatibility.
Well, they've already said there's no physical backwards compatibility.
But your average consumer isn't going to know that. And your average consumer probably doesn't have bought in the Wii U.
Yeah, well, according to the sales, they obviously haven't.
No.
But
so throwing all that aside, it's not going to be your second screen DS sort of. You're playing on both screens.
And I think it's good. I think Nintendo experimented with it. It obviously wasn't a hit on the in the.
It wasn't even used.
Well, it was used for very few games.
Pikmin. I always look at that trailer for Wii U and the kid's playing Fruit Ninja, and he has the gamepad slid by the side, and he's throwing the shurikens at it. But aside from Nintendo Land and a few other games, I can't think of
Lego
any
City
other
Undercover.
Thing that needed it.
You had the Rayman game.
Oh, yeah, which got delayed through hell just because those features had to work.
Yeah, that was
a huge problem, a huge turnoff for a developer.
And then they ended up releasing it on every other platform.
Yeah, yeah, it's exclusive for Wii U.
I bought it for Wii U.
I got it for free on Xbox One.
And got it. I bought it on Xbox One.
Oh, wow. You poor chump.
I was very, very inebriated. And I'm like, oh, man, I really want to play Rayman right now. I bought it at George's house.
Wow, what a waste. The absolute waste of money. It became free like 4 months later.
It was only like, I only got it for like 15 bucks.
Oh,
I mean, for 15 bucks, the game is a ton of fun.
It's a great game.
Oh, yeah.
It's tons of fun. Rayman Revelations.
That's
some kind of standard AAA.
That's Mastery Bro stuff.
Yeah, that definitely is, but it's Ubisoft, so who knows?
Yeah, who knows anymore?
I like that what makes this seem more like, you know, it's not going to be that whole second screen, it's not falling into that, is that when you literally dock it, the screen is covered.
Yes, and that is a smart design decision.
Yes.
So
this is more of the same. I just felt like throwing Polygon in here.
I'm trying to see if they have a better shot. If anybody has a better shot of this section of the console.
Yeah. I'd like to know what it looks like, but we've already looked at that article on the side. This is just more of the same of saying, you know, your 3DS cards aren't going to work.
Yeah.
Your Wii U discs aren't going to work. There's no external.
Right.
It could be, what, an external Wii U?
External disk drive.
Disk drive. What year is it?
What 2016, because Apple still sells one.
I actually bought one recently. Used it to burn DVDs.
Like, not even joking.
Apple USB.
Because
$80. $80.
I should remind you, this is a thing, and you could actually buy it now.
Wow, 2.5 stars. Maybe it's like Netflix, where it's like something that you wouldn't need.
The sleek, compact USB
Super Drive.
Super Drive.
Oh, man. Apple should name all the things for Nintendo. The Super Wii.
Yeah, what's funny is their naming convention was so stupid. Like, you had combo drives and super drives.
For what?
On their laptops. Street Fighter? No. This is Apple laptops.
Wow.
So a combo drive was a DVD player with a CD writer.
Okay.
And a super drive was a DVD burner.
That's incredible. That's incredible. Imagine if Apple sold like gasoline. Super high definition.
Well, we already have that.
Retina unleaded.
Retina unleaded fuel. Yeah, could you fill me up? I need $20 of Retina unleaded, please.
Will that be the Retina unleaded or the Super Retina unleaded combo?
With Force Touch, please.
Oh my gosh. You got to update your gas station every couple months with a free OS that does nothing. Mac OS Sierra.
Did you update your phone?
Yeah, it's on
That is one of the reasons.
It's on iOS, can't find the flashlight feature. Turns out it's from the left side of the bottom.
You should,
I can't.
You should be able to just...
Okay. Flick it from the bottom. I thought it was from the left side. Yeah. I don't know. Well, every time I get near the bottom, it unlocks because I'm pressing the button.
I don't know. I hate iOS. I can unlock. I can hit that pretty reliably.
It's legit the worst.
No joke. The whole screen lifting up thing was like, all right, I'm done. I'm done with the iPhone. We're out.
Yeah, I don't. And you know what? I look at it immediately, and then it lights up. I hate that. Samsung does that.
No, it doesn't.
What does the S5? Does the S5 do that? What am I thinking of?
Do you have the always on screen on?
I have no idea. Probably.
I turn all that shit off.
I probably have that on.
But that one feature made me rage quit the iPhone.
What?
The whole screen lifting up, turning on the screen. I'm like, I fidget with my phone all the time. Like, I will toss it in my hand.
You think you're getting a text.
And the screen lights up all the time, and I'm like, oh, well. All right. Screen lights up. Oh, what's this?
Nothing.
And I'm
the
like,
time.
I'm like, I'm done. We're done. Selling the iPhone. We're out.
Okay.
Rage quit.
Aside from the iPhones, let's get back to Nintendo. Closing thoughts, I think.
We've beaten this horse to death.
We've beaten it to death.
And the recording timer would agree with me.
All right. So let's give final thoughts. Price and games that will be coming out, and that's it.
So... pricing, $200 or bust. That's it. $200 or bust. What else? Games. 3 first party games. 6.
That's including Zelda.
Yes, and 6 third party games minimum. So I want 9 games. Virtual console at launch would be great, but I want virtual console within the within year one.
No, virtual console needs to be at launch.
Okay,
that's what I that
needs
You're to
be very
launch.
Firm on that one.
Virtual console needs to be at launch. I know Nintendo is also selling the NES USB Classic, whatever thing, the small compact.
Oh yeah, yeah.
40 games on it. Maybe not try to bleed that over with Switch, but you know what? They're two separate markets.
Right, right.
So it's
fine. I think it's good. Nintendo has something for the holiday season. It's a fun little device to tide people over.
Yeah. No, I think that virtual... this is what I think. A Nintendo system should come prepackaged with like 10 best virtual console games. Like, you got your Mario 3, you got your...
I don't even think you need that many. I think you need like...
Super Mario World.
I think you put like Super Mario. If you're gonna pick,
maybe
like,
not 10, maybe 5.
Like Legend of Zelda, Super Mario World, maybe Super Metroid, Mario 64.
I was thinking Super Nintendo and older.
Give me one more. What would be one final one?
Some different. I don't know. F-Zero.
Maybe like Wave Race. Why not? It's just something like something out
Super
there.
Smash Bros. For N64. Something. Just Ocarina like, of Time.
Yeah.
Wow.
That would end the world.
That would be great.
That's how you sell consoles.
But you have that built in. So, you know, you always went to that game where it was like, you know, you'd rent something.
Right,
and then
right.
You would, I don't know, you play your other games. It's your game that you would have. Virtual console on launch, under $300.
So you're going to say it under 300.
I think 300 okay. and under. 300 and under. That's what it should be at. 300 would be okay. I buy it.
Fair.
I'm going to buy it anyway, but... Breath of the Wild at launch, ports to come of other games soon within the window, and maybe 2 other first-party games.
All right.
Third-party, Skyrim, whatever. On there. Done.
All right.
Done.
So we're going to wrap up. Again, thank you for tuning in to episode 91. This is the first show we've had in way too long.
1 year.
About a year now, yeah. So we'll get this up on YouTube. Follow us on YouTube, youtube.com/GenGameNet, facebook.com/GenGame. Follow us on Twitter. Interact with the troll meister himself, Kevin O'Rourke, at GenGame. And also follow us on Twitter. I'm at the Mags. Kevin is at Shabazzle. And this was the GenGameCast. So thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you next week.